we're back. I'm going to be painting Indian blanket flowers now up around him. He's kind of nestled into the Indian blanket flowers. They'll be on here, then they'll come back behind and go back near the sculpture back there. I've gone ahead and painted Hobo's hindquarters in there because some of these flowers are going to kind of break in front of him. I'm using mixtures of cadmium red deep, cadmium red deep plus some magenta, which makes a nice deep red. Then I'm using cadmium red deep and then cadmium red light. This is the cadmium red deep plus magenta. And the centers of these flowers are a deep red, or the near the center is deep red, and then as the petals go out they get oranges and reds and really pretty, and then the tips of the petals are actually yellow. So I'm going to start bringing in some of my cadmium red light here. Use a smaller brush, and again I'm using a bright brush, but you can see I can just use the bristle sideways to make the detail of the petals. I'm just blocking in color here right now. I'm going to work the greens around this, but I just kind of want to get this area covered and then I'll come back and do the detail. Let me step around the camera. I'm going to paint this side of the canvas here. And over that green, I just gently lay the paint on top of the green, so I don't pick up that green. See how that picks up on my brush? So I have to clean my brush each time so I don't dirty my reds of my flowers. Once I get down here on the clean canvas, then I don't have to worry. But once I'm up here in the greens, then I have to make sure that my brush is good and clean. Let's bring some flowers in here. They'll break down. This is going to be grass in the foreground, and these flowers will just break down over that. I paint my flowers first. I get those blocked in first, then I paint the greens. And the reason I do that, in fact, you saw that, if I painted the green first and then tried to come back with the red, my brush would pick up that red and dirty my flower color. So I want to do my flower colors first, and then come back with the greens. Now back here where I've already got my knockout roses painted in, I have to go back over that green. So again, I just carefully lay the paint on top of the green and then I clean my brush each time. So I don't want that to mess up my color. And these Indian blanket flowers are just a border along this flower bed that the sculpture is in. Again, this is at Texas Tech University. That's in Lubbock. And this flower bed is not actually there, but we're making it up to make a better composition for our portrait. Actually, there's lots of buildings back behind that, and we just decided that that would be too conflicting with this portrait of Hobo, since he's the main star of our show. We don't want the buildings to be cluttering the background. I'm going to also work a few blue bonnets in there too, so there'll be some breaks in these flowers where some blue bonnets will come in. Now, begin putting my greens in here. These are mixes of phthalo blue plus cadmium yellow. No, what? These are phthalo blue plus lemon yellow, excuse me. Some of these leaves break out. I don't want to totally cover over these white marks on Hobo. So that's a distinctive markings on his coat. But I do want these flowers to break out in front of him because he's kind of nestled in. These flowers, kind of nestled in the flower bed. In fact, I think I may have a few coming up behind him. Just in here. And then a few back here. Well, I don't know that I'm going to put any in there because he's going to be wearing a red bandana around his neck, and I don't want them to conflict with that bandana. So I'm not going to put any more up there. But now I go ahead and start blocking in my leaves. And I use the greens to kind of shape, give my flowers some shape. And I also use some mixtures of just phthalo blue plus white to give us a little cool blues into that green. Give a little coolness in the foliage. And then this is pure phthalo blue plus some liquin. That gives me just a nice dark. My grass is going to be breaking up in front of these. See how I can use just the corner of that brush to really get some fine strokes. Go around this side and do the edge of the canvas here. The canvas is mounted on a piece of double-ply cardboard. I put screw eyes into the back of the stretcher bars and then let them stick out, and then I poke that through the cardboard, and the screw eyes stick out just enough that I can stick a nail through them, and then they hold the canvas tight to the board. And this makes it very easy for me to handle this painting while it's wet. Since it's painted all the way around the edges, it would be very, very difficult to handle otherwise. And I make it enough larger out that I can build up a side that sticks up above the painting and then put cardboard over the top of that, and that's how I ship these paintings. And they arrive and the gallery takes them, or the collector, this one's going directly to the collector. They take them out of the, cut the box off of them and take them off that backing cardboard. Your painting's ready to hang. By the time it gets to them, it'll be dry, so they can handle it. Okay, so we've got that bunch of flowers blocked in. Let's go ahead here and do these back here. I'm going to bring some greens in here because, again, that's going to be a red bandana, and I don't want those reds to fight with that. These get smaller as they go back. They're going back quite a bit to get back to that sculpture. I'm going to bring some of that base of the sculpture down. I save my colors so that I can always go back in if I need to make any corrections or whatever, like I got those flowers too high. So I can come back in here with some of my colors from the base of that sculpture and paint back over that red didn't like them going up that high. Even back here, I can come back. And now this part of the sculpture base is in shadow. There'll be a tree off the right side of the painting that's just throwing a shadow across there. Okay. I think this is going to be better. Have those smaller back there, because it'll be smaller in proportion. This edge is a little darker. And then take some of my blue. This is actually some of the blue from the mountain laurel trees here in the background. But I can just work that into the wet paint of the sculpture base, and it cools it and makes it go back behind the roses. Now I can bring some of those rose leaves out. And even I've saved my rose colors, so I can even bring a few of those knockout roses up over here. Get little darks just along the bottom here with my phthalo blue plus liquid. Just cut a little more of my base down into these. Now I'm cleaning my brush each time because I want that base color to stay clean. I use a lot of tissue, and I just wipe the paint out of the brush. And I can pull from the base down, and then I don't pull that red into the base. Again, I'm going to have some other blue bonnets and stuff in there. I'll do that later. I picked up that little bit of that red. In fact, I'm going to go ahead and scrape this with my painting knife to get those clumps of red out of there. Now this makes it easier to bring my sculpture base down over that. Okay, we've got our Indian paintbrush. No, these are not Indian paintbrush, excuse me. These are Indian blanket flowers. We also have an Indian paintbrush wildflower in Texas too. But these are Indian blankets. They're blocked in. So this is part one. I'll show you part two. I'll finish up the flowers. So thank you for watching my YouTube videos. I also have a blog where I show the complete step-by-step paint process of my paintings. The address is in the description below, the link to the website. Also, my blog address is on the final frame of the video. You have a wonderful, wonderful day, and I hope you'll come watch part two.